down the street. It's a beautiful day. Come on, let's visit Mrs. Kane and Miss Jane. They always have something fun to say on Porch Story Today.
Why, hello! Hi, everyone.
Welcome back to Porch Stories.
I know, it's Porch Stories. This is our, Ms. Kane, I think this is our third episode.
Yes.
In season two. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. We're so glad you could join us. So we're going to start out a little bit different today, aren't we, Ms. Kane?
Yes, we are.
So we know that usually we start out with our little mindful
singing
breathing.
Bowl.
Yeah, and the singing bowl.
The singing bowl with our mindful breathing exercise. Today, not everybody has a singing bowl,
no.
So we're going to try this exercise without a singing bowl.
Oh, I love that.
We're going to do a mindful five breath.
Wait, you know what? I feel like today I might need a little extra breathing, so let's do the five breath.
We're going to do a five breath breathing exercise to calm ourselves down and to get ourselves ready to be focused on listening to the story, okay?
And it's kind of like you know, and maybe you're eating at your cereal bowl, so just take a moment, get yourself together and focus, and Ms. Kane, go ahead and guide us on this.
Okay, so here we go. It's gonna be five breaths, starting now. That was perfect.
Oh, that really worked out nice.
I
got really calm.
Yes.
I know. Well, we always, Ms. Kane and I always get excited when we're getting ready to do one of these, don't we, Ms. Kane?
Yes, we do.
You know, and we're so happy that you've chosen time to join us for this. And it's a very colorful front porch here on Porch Stories today, like always. And Ms. Kane, what book do you have for us today?
Van Gogh Paints the Night Sky. Vincent Can't Sleep.
Oh my goodness.
By Barb Rosenstock, illustrated by Mary GrandPré.
Oh, nice. And I think that either the author or the illustrator is an award winner, isn't that correct?
Well, no, it's from the team behind the Caldecott Honor Book,
nice.
The Noisy Paint Box.
So, and that's for another artist. We'll share that maybe another time, right?
Yes, yes.
So our artist today is artist Vincent Van Gogh.
Vincent Van Gogh.
And I will have to say, Miss Kane, as a young Miss Jane, he was my first art boyfriend.
Oh.
I had a big crush on Van Gogh. Yes. And it's continued through the rest of my life.
I was going to say, I think you still have this crush on him.
It's okay. It is a healthy relationship. And we, you know, I've come to terms with that. So I'm excited to hear how this author takes on his life. Now, I do have a question for you.
Yes.
Because it looks like there's lots of beautiful pictures, but then this is a book that is a biography.
It's in the 921s, GOG. For Van Gogh,
right?
921s is the biography section, and it's just a plain old biography because it was not written by Vincent Van Gogh.
No, he did not write this one.
He did not write this one. If he would have written this one, it would have been an autobiography. But it's just a biography written by other people and illustrated by other people.
But about a real person who
yes.
really lived.
Yes.
And that's what I think is so interesting is we can have different approaches to true stories.
Yes.
So they can have lots of photos and illustrations. You don't have to think that just because something's a true story, there's not going to be any pictures, right?
Yes. So shall we start?
Yes, please do. I'm excited.
Van Gogh Paints the Night Sky, Vincent Can't Sleep by Barb Rosenstock, illustrated by Mary GrandPré, Alfred A. Knopp, New York. So all that information, those four things, the title, the author, the illustrator, and the publishing company is the title page. So this is what every book has is a title page, and this is the title page for this particular book.
Perfect.
And look at it. It has beautiful, beautiful pictures.
Oh, I love that. We'll add some close-ups, too, for
yes.
this, so I'm loving that.
Vincent can't sleep.
Oh, boy.
So while the sturdy Dutch village of Zundert slumbers. He lies rocking in his wooden cradle, flame-haired, a constellation of freckles sprinkled his cheeks. His shining eyes change color, first blue, then green, and dart after pink and yellow starlit shapes that twinkle on the ceiling.
So right there, we're kind of learning that Vincent is a redhead. You know, they talk about his flaming hair.
And he had freckles.
And I love how they call them like constellations.
Yes.
That's a really nice
so
way to kind of think.
He had kind of bluish-green eyes,
yes,
too. Vincent can't sleep. Mother will fuss. Father will frown. He might wake his little brother, Theo. In half-light, his pencil drawings flicker on the sloping beams of their attic room.
Oh my goodness.
So this is where I guess his bedroom was.
I think so, up in the upstairs. You know, and it's not going to be an attic like what we think of. It's probably just like an unfinished room, you know, but more like a loft, I'm thinking.
You could still see the beams.
Exactly.
The beams. Carrying laced-up leather boots, he tiptoes down narrow pine stairs, turns the front latch, inching the door open to a wild shimmering of midnight air. Vincent can't sleep.
Oh, boy.
Out, out, out he runs, flying through the garden. Marigold, geranium, blackberry, raspberry.
And I love in this illustration, you're going to see where there's like a black and white. And that's kind of, they're showing an illustration in the style of his drawings. And then it goes to color on the other side. Mm-hmm. So like a sketchbook and then a painting.
Yes. Well, I kind of think that he felt that there was lots of color at night when a lot of people
didn't think there was color at night. I can totally see that when you're saying like when he steps outside. You know what it reminds me of in the movie The Wizard of Oz?
Yes.
When she opens the door?
Yes.
I love that.
Past the church with its tall steeple, down rolling hills and sandy paths meant for sheep, he dives at last into the velvety violet heath, snuggles under a blanket of sapphire sky and looks up, up, up to visit with the stars.
Oh my gosh. That looks so comfortable.
I know.
That looks very comfortable.
These are things that he saw, and he would draw, paint things.
Absolutely.
That he saw.
Well, and what this illustrator is showing us is little glimmers of the future Van Gogh. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Little icons and images that really show up in his artwork later.
Vincent can't sleep.
Uh-oh.
Away at boarding school in bigger towns, Zevenbergen, Tilburg, dull classes, colorless teachers.
Oh, no.
Rainbowed memories of home. While other students study, play, and laugh together, Vincent draws, writes, and sighs alone. He runs into the soothing darkness and is brought back to the harsh light over and over again. So I'm kind of like, the parts that's dull to him is kind of in the dull color.
Yeah, with the dull colors,
and
then
when he's thinking of like home.
Right. He's got things in the bright colors. I mean, and really as artists, a lot of times we'll have a sketchbook and we might only have pencils, and it's just the outline of the idea.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you go to the painting or the color pencils, watercolor, oil painting, whatever you're doing, that's when you can put the pops of color in. It's not saying all black and white art is dull, but a lot of times we do sketches to give us an idea.
It's kind of a framework. I forget the word for it.
Yeah, but it's like you're setting up an idea. You're collecting notes. A sketchbook a lot of times is the way an artist collects notes.
Vincent can't sleep.
Oh, no, poor baby.
Though he's grown, working in gleaming cities, The Hague, London, Paris, he stocks and sells paintings in uncle's fashionable galleries. Excited, bored, eager, lazy, explosive, shy. His many colored moves scare the customers.
Uh-oh.
And he's forced to go.
Uh-oh. So when you look on here, so Van Gogh actually had family members who owned galleries. His brother Theo was actually involved in art trade.
Three uncles.
Yeah, and he had three uncles that were involved in the whole art business. And, you know, those cities that you named, those are very famous cities that had a lot of very famous art. Mm-hmm. And what you're looking at is like it was neoclassicism, romanticism at the time was the most popular art form. And you also had what's called realism. So it's a very recognizable images. But coming up, dun, 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 mm-hmm. are the Impressionists. And those are the guys and gals that played with light. And they were no longer restricted by the confines of reality, I will say, because the camera had been invented, Miss Kane, and that changed one of the focus, no pun intended, of art. Go ahead.
Vincent Can't Sleep, wandering west in England, south in Belgium, teaching, shopping, shopkeeping, preaching. His letters fill with roadside scenes, peasants and thunderclouds inked along the way. Now he calls himself an artist. The neighbors whisper. His family worries. Is Vincent lost? He drifts hundreds of miles in a tattered hat and cloak, framing haloed sunsets with charcoal-stained hands.
Oh, my goodness. So he tried to be a minister, and he actually attempted that profession. But, you know, he was so intense, Miss Kane. He was such an intense character. He had such passion and drive and energy that it wasn't the kind of personality that brought people towards him like you would want for a minister or preacher.
His intensity
was a bit terrifying to people. And so he was not able to pursue a life in the ministry.
Vincent can't sleep and won't stop painting. He's found his light. After scattering lessons from proper artists, he takes off, canvas and paints strapped to his back.
So he is the kind of artist that believes that you have to see what you're going to paint.
Yes.
You know, like some people will paint from memory or dreams or photographs or whatever. He wants to be in the field where he's painting. So if he's painting flowers, they're going to be in front of him. If he's painting you, you're going to be in front of him, you know. And he was very prolific, very prolific artist.
Flashing brushstrokes capture country cottages at dusk. City cafes at midnight, canvas after canvas, like radiant chapters in a book only Vincent can read.
Oh, and really, he kind of, what's one of the things that I think is so interesting with him is that he painted still lifes, he painted portraits, he painted self-portraits, he painted landscapes. There really wasn't a genre that he did not approach and try.
He discovers that darkness is not plain black. Galaxies of color float on the night air.
And that's kind of giving us a hint into probably his most famous painting.
Yes.
You know, and some of you probably know it too, I'm thinking. There's just a few hints here with Kane of that painting.
Just a few.
Vincent
can't sleep. Shut tight in a hospital, told to rest as dark hills wave past his window, first blue, then green. He pictures a snuggling village of flaming cypress, a tall steeple pointing up, up, up. Waits for morning when he's allowed to paint and asks himself wild questions.
Oh, boy. So Vincent van Gogh had throughout his entire life a lot of mental struggles. And, you know, mental illness is not anything to be ashamed of, and it's something that numerous people can suffer from. And unfortunately, at the time that he lived, there were really limited approaches to how to deal with it. There wasn't a medication that made it so you could still function in the world. A lot of times it just knocked you out, right? And they would wait for these so-called episodes to pass. He had doctors who tried to look after him. He went to numerous hospitals to rest up. But, I mean, we're all right now still in the middle of a COVID lockdown, and a lot of us are having anxiety and stress. Wouldn't you say, Miss Kane?
Yes, we are.
So I would never want to be a person that would do any kind of shaming of mental health. And so what you want to do is look at ways that you can kind of give yourself kindness and love. And if you need help, seek help.
Well,
asking a question is good.
Like Vincent, I find myself sometimes I can't sleep.
I know. I agree, Miss Kane. And so so tell somebody. That's probably, you know, share your burden so that you can get the support and love that you need so that you stay healthy.
Exactly.
Because we've got so many great options today.
Yes, we do.
There's so many great choices that our poor Vincent didn't have.
He did not have.
I know.
And so these are the wild questions he asked himself. Does darkness have texture? Thick? Thin?
Oh, my goodness.
Does it have a rhythm? Quick? Slow? Is the night sky at rest? Or do 11 stars pulse like a beating heart?
And that 11 stars is alluding to the 11 stars you'll find in Starry Night. So he's kind of giving us that little, the author is.
Yes.
And those words that he used, texture.
Yes.
Van Gogh is known for such textured canvases where he would load the brush up. And he's now what considered what we call a post-impressionist. So those are the guys that came after the impressionist, okay?
Then his painting stands finished.
Oh.
A whirling, moonlit dream reflecting the warm sun. Bold and infinite, like the wandering Milky Way, strange and restless, like Vincent himself. A sensitive boy, a hidden genius, a brilliant artist, the one who knows best the many colors of night.
Oh, and he really, when you look at his paintings that are of night, it is not a steel black sky. You're going to see in there blues. You're going to see purples. You'll obviously see the yellows and the white. And so it makes the sky come alive, and it appears movement. A lot of paintings
not
with
just
movement.
One color.
No.
Shh. Oh. Vincent's asleep.
Oh my gosh, that is just, what a beautifully illustrated book. And I think, are there some author notes in
yes,
there in
there
the back
is,
that you wanted to share? And then I'll share a couple images here too. So go ahead and I'll interject while you're giving the author notes.
Author's note. Vincent van Gogh often couldn't sleep. From boyhood on, he was plagued with long bouts of insomnia in addition to many other symptoms of mental or physical illness. These kept him awake, wandering while others slept. Once around the age of 9 or 10, he walked at night alone from his hometown in Zundert in the Netherlands and was found with torn clothes and muddy shoes in a town 6 miles away in the country of Belgium.
Oh my goodness!
As he grew older, he painted productively and lived much of his life in the hours between dusk and dawn.
So he's definitely a night owl.
Van Gogh's work included nearly 900 paintings, most completed in the years between 1881 and 1890.
Yep.
Vincent's art was influenced by the Barbizon school painter Jean-François Millet, as well as the impressionist Claude Monet and Camille Pissarro.
And Pissarro just, I have, this is an example of a couple of the impressionists. So when they're talking about the impressionist artists, like this is a beautiful painting by Renoir. And these would have been the kinds of art pieces that, you know, he would have seen. And this is a painting right here we've got by Degas. And these are the types of images that he would have seen early on in his artistic pursuit. And it would have challenged him on how to present color,
mm-hmm.
you know, how to paint down color. Pissarro did beautiful landscapes. I mean, they're like, it looks like you're painting with cotton candy.
Ugh.
You know, they're just gorgeous.
And post-impressionist Georges Seurat.
Seurat, yeah, with the dots.
Paul Signac and Paul Gauguin.
Yeah, Paul Gauguin. Don't get me started, Ms. Kane, about Paul Gauguin, okay? Ms. Jane is just going to say they had a huge fight. I'm on Vincent's side. I don't care what Gauguin had to say. He needed to step off. That's all I'm going to say on that, okay?
She's told me many times.
I have.
Few people during his lifetime appreciated Van Gogh's artistic talent. He was known more for his passionate energy and manic moodiness.
Oh, boy.
Though he's now considered one of history's greatest artists, experts believe he sold fewer than 5 paintings in his lifetime.
Yes.
His dramatic paintings of sunflowers and irises use bright daytime colors, but many of his masterpieces are set in and around darkness, including the visionary oil painting, The Starry Night,
mm-hmm.
completed in 1889 while he was being treated at a hospital for those with mental illness in the town of Saint-Rémy-de-Provence in southern France.
They think, too, that the way that he positioned the stars, they're actually able to kind of tell what time of night it was when he did that.
Amazing.
I mean, that just, it's so precise. And if you get a chance to see a print of it, if you get a chance to see the real thing, that's even more amazing. But it's just hypnotic in its beauty and its balance. With the cypress tree and the moon, he balanced a canvas and he made what we would consider a background, the sky, seem like the foreground because it's so vivid. It comes alive.
The Starry Night combines reality with imagination and is widely considered one of the most important paintings in history.
I agree.
The scene is based partially on Van Gogh's eastern-facing view from his bedroom window at the hospital.
Right.
He could see a wheat field and the night sky over rolling hills, but he could not see a village from his room. The twinkling town in the starry night is composed from earlier sketches of Saint-Rémy, memories of his hometown of Zundert, and some imagined combination. He sketched many versions of this scene in pen and charcoal, but doctors did not allow him to paint in his room. The starry night was painted during the day between June 16th and 18th, 1889, in the studio Vincent had set up downstairs. The problem of painting darkness that is still color is one that Vincent van Gogh wrestled with throughout his short, brilliant life. He solved it by loading his brushes with paint, then swirling or dashing strokes of complementary colors, reds with greens,
yes,
purple with yellows,
beautiful,
blues with oranges, which created luminous night scenes. His oil paintings demonstrate a masterful knowledge of composition, color mixing, and painting technique, such as impasto. Did I say that right?
You're fine.
A painting thickly.
That is it, impasto. So it almost looks like cake icing.
Yes.
Okay, I mean, I know I make a lot of food references, but I think that visually when you're thinking mm-hmm, about mm-hmm. it and you see the way the colors blend on the canvas,
it's not flat.
And I'm sure in museums, people just want to touch a Van Gogh all the time. I'm sure the guards are like, step back, because they have such a tactile appeal.
A draw, kind of a draw.
Yes, it would just pull you in.
Vincent's personality shines through his art with each energetic brushstroke and wild color choice. He brings the night to life. And so then it just shows.
Well, and I think to put this in perspective of the time that his art is arriving on the scene, and to only sell, and early on they thought he had only sold one painting. And there's been different descriptions. Did he give a painting in trade? Mm-hmm. Was there medical services? Because he did do paintings of his doctors.
Mm-hmm.
He painted pictures of people in his community. So did he give those paintings as service for, like, say, getting food or treatment? And would that
like
be
a barter
same?
System?
Exactly. So would that be the same as selling a painting? His brother, sadly, Van Gogh died before he was even 38 years old, self-inflicted gunshot wound, and it took him several days to pass over. His brother Theo was able to be at his bedside. His brother Theo was his biggest champion.
Best friend.
And you know, you might have a family member who just supports you in everything. You're doing great in soccer. You can play guitar. You can be anything. You might have a family or community member who supports you like that. And Theo and Van Gogh wrote letters. Sadly, 6 months later, Theo passes away.
Mm-hmm.
And Theo's wife preserved all of those letters, and which is why today, Miss Kane, we have as much information about Van Gogh and Theo's relationship, because she knew those were important.
Mm-hmm.
Today, Vincent Van Gogh is viewed as one of the most significant artists of the 20th century, if not of all time.
Of all time.
You know, if not, I mean, of the, so it's like he is just viewed, well, actually it would be the 19th century because he was, no, 20th century, 1890, so he'd be the 19th century. Oh my gosh, I'm having to do upper math.
You know,
I apologize.
It's hard. Sometimes it's hard to get your brain going because
well, for me,
this rustiness.
Ms. Kane, I would just say he's timeless. So yes. I would say he's also of the 20th century, but don't tell anybody else.
I won't tell.
So, and if you really want to see something heartfelt, I'm just going to do a little shout out to Doctor Who. They have a beautiful episode in which they time travel and visit Vincent Van Gogh.
Mm-hmm.
And Van Gogh is, you know, he's struggling. He's having a lot of conflict, and they secretly bring him to the present to witness his impact on human life. And I just think that's one of the most beautiful summaries. And I watch it almost every year. I just get this little tear just thinking about it.
Well, that's because he's your boyfriend.
So as you can see, Ms. Kane, we have a plethora of books that want to know more.
Yes, plenty.
If you want to know more, these books, they're going to be in the biography non-section mm-hmm. of your library, whether it's the David Lubin Library, our public library, your school library where you attend school,
mm-hmm.
and so seek them out, because there's so much more
to learn. So much more information. I really wanted to read this, but it had just way too much.
Oh, it is a lot. That would be like the 3-hour porch story. Yes, because we would have to have snacks, and you know, it would just involve, there'd probably be some croissants involved with that.
Yeah, maybe.
But it does, it has beautiful illustrations. It has copies of letters in there, too.
There's a letter that he wrote to his brother that you said his brother's wife kept.
Yeah, she kept all of those. So we have a print here from the sunflowers, and he did a series of these, and he actually had some where they started dying, and he painted them like that because he just thought those were beautiful, too. And people were just stunned that he would paint flowers and the color of the background so similar. I signed his name right here. So... Oops. On that note, my friends, I think we're just going to wrap it up here. Did you have anything else that you wanted to share or show them?
We wanted to tell them to be safe.
Oh, we do want you guys. Yes. So we'll be having another episode of Porch Stories coming up. Yes. So be on the lookout. We are so glad that you joined us. We want you to be safe, be smart, and look at this and, you know, and read up on art, right?
And enjoy art, huh?
Oh, yes.
Be safe, be smart, and enjoy art.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Goodbye.